Let's start going through some of the generic editing techniques that you use every day. I have some media loaded in the source viewer, and I want to edit it into the sequence. The sequence consists of a few shots already cut together. At this point, you have a few choices how to perform the edit. To the right of the menu bar, you will see three icons. The first button with a yellow indicator is Insert Edit. This will ripple the sequence from the point of the positioner or in and out marks. You can also press F9 to perform an insert edit with the keyboard. I'll just undo that operation by pressing Command Z. The second button with a red indicator is the Overwrite Edit. You can also press F10 to perform an overwrite edit with the keyboard. This will overwrite any of the existing shots from the point of the positioner or in and out marks. The third button in the row contains a whole bunch of additional editing functionality. The default operation is Replace Media, but expanding the drop-down menu shows that you can align edit, append, prepend, ripple replace, and fit to fill. An additional tool for preparing your edit is the thumbnail view for storyboard editing. Go to the View pull-down menu and change the mode from Source Sequence to Thumbnail View. To determine what you see in the thumbnail view is controlled in the Media panel. Next to the library and every folder, you will see a small empty box. If any of the boxes contain an eye icon, this tells you what library or folder you are looking at in the thumbnail view. You can only view the contents of one library or folder in the thumbnail view at any time. To switch the thumbnail view between libraries and folders, just click on the corresponding empty square to display the contents. Compared to other non-linear editors, this would be the equivalent of viewing your source thumbnails in a bin. The thumbnails are sitting in a free-floating environment. To tidy up the thumbnails, click on the gear pull-down menu, choose Arrange, and select Clean Up All. You can now go through the process of organizing your media in a storyboard edit. You can scrub the thumbnails, play the media, as well as mark them up for the edit. Once you have made your creative editorial choices, you select your first shot of the edit, and then hold down Command and click through the rest of the shots in the correct order. You will notice that as you select the clips, they are also being selected in the media library. It doesn't matter where you select your clips, whether in the thumbnail view or the media library. With all the clips selected, drag the selection down to the sequence. When you release the cursor, the edit will be created in the sequence. Now change the view mode from Thumbnail View to Source Sequence View, or press Option 2. I don't know if you noticed the editing indicators when I dragged the clips into the sequence. I'll undo what I did with Command Z, and then I'll drag the selection back into the edit. Without releasing the cursor, I'll hover the selection over Video Track 1. The editing indicators on the left of the selection indicate which track of the sequence the selected clips will be edited into. When the selection is aligned with a track, the edit will be placed on the respective track. However, if the selection was placed above any existing tracks, a new track will be created and the selected clips will be edited onto the new track. Just remember that drag and drop editing will affect the sequence in different ways. This is dependent on whether or not the ripple mode is active. This button is to the right, located above the sequence. You can toggle it on or off using the Shift-R keyboard shortcut. Please move on to the next video to continue your smoke getting started experience.